Good afternoon, everybody, east, west, north, south, worldwide, and welcome to the Hood Point.
What's up?
I'm Keith Allen, and along with me is Sean C.
Yes.
And E Rumble.
Yes, sir. Yes,
we missing G Host today. He making them biscuits, but shouts out to G Host. Later on, he'll be at the bar for bar doing big things.
Yes.
What's going on, gentlemen? So,
hey, man. Hey, Sean, you see how he nicely did say your host?
Hey, I was going to bring that up.
I did that last week, too, though.
Yeah, he did. Yeah,
you know, I'm still trying to figure out how you the host and we the co-host, and we all co-hosts. But, you know, it's all right. It's all right.
It's like one of them, it ain't really no big thing. You know what I'm saying? It's just like, I ain't saying like I'm the host, but you
yeah,
know
right.
Nah.
But I do.
Yeah. Right. that's okay. I got a dump button back here.
There we go.
Thank you.
There we go. Thank you.
Dump button. Y'all can't dump me.
Yes, I can.
Okay. Very quickly.
Watch
very
us.
Quickly.
What's going on, fellas?
Nothing much.
See how that works?
Yep.
See how that works?
Just cut you off.
No,
so what's happening, Sean?
I had a great week. Son graduated on Sunday, officially got the piece of paper. Hey, man.
You're not part of the show. You're off right now.
Yeah, I'm off, but I'm saying,
still on.
Like, son officially graduated, walked across the stage, saw it. It's a beautiful thing. Held back the tears.
Yeah, son.
Saw a lot of people from Shaw. A lot of their kids go to Euclid, I found out. So,
shout out to everybody. I have noticed that.
Yeah, you know, shout out to all of them, you know, especially Brendan.
There you go.
Yes, sir.
You know, it's quite funny how you see all these people you know. It's like, yeah, you was getting busy around the same time I was.
Right.
It was like a baby boom in 1995.
Right.
Oh, man, I saw so many familiar faces. It was crazy.
Right.
Oh, I know.
But that's good. What's his, he's going to school, anything?
Youngstown State, yes.
Good.
That's good.
That's good.
What he's going to major in?
I do believe it's child psychology.
Okay.
Yeah, gotcha. So he's going to be in there for a minute. So dad's going to be poor for a while. But it's cool.
That's cool.
It's cool. I support that.
Great thing.
Go get that, son.
I know that's right. That's
got
right.
you.
Yes. You know. Stay focused.
Please.
Yeah, right.
It's too hard out here.
So, I'm going to start this off. You know, I got a question. Did y'all see my man Chad Ochocinco this week?
Oh, I'm glad you brought that up. That is so ridiculous.
Yeah.
So ridiculous. So ridiculous.
It's crazy.
So how do y'all feel about that?
Okay, first of all, you want me to kick this off?
Yeah, kick it off.
Okay. First of all, he didn't do anything trying to be funny, really. I think not that he was on autopilot, but he just, you know, the judge told him to thank the lawyer for, you know, getting him off.
And technically,
he did it in the football way. Yeah,
right. He
did it in the football way. It was not his fault that everybody bust out laughing.
You see the bailiff that's right in front of him?
I was going to say, he's right in the middle of the camera laughing. So did he get fired?
No.
No.
See, I don't get it. I think she was just grandstanding at that point. She was looking for a reason to come after him. So, somebody said earlier in the week, she was looking for a show.
Yeah.
I think she was trying to be the next Judge
Maybe she
Judy.
Wants to be the next heir apparent to Judge Judy.
Yeah,
exactly.
I think so, too.
And that wasn't cool.
No, it wasn't.
30
it wasn't.
Days?
Yeah. I heard he's trying to appeal the sentencing. He's trying to overturn it. So
I mean, there's no way that he can stay in jail for 30 days for that.
I think he'll probably do about 10 at the most.
Yeah. I mean, she'll catch so much heat that they got to let him go. I mean, she's catching heat now.
Yeah.
Because nobody's really backing that up. Like, he did something that's so egregious. He really didn't.
Because when you first heard about it and you didn't see no video or nothing, I'm like, well, what do you have, a female lawyer or something?
Yeah, when I first heard it, you know, I saw him. I seen him do it, but I didn't know. I didn't see the beginning part when she told him, you need to big up your lawyer for doing such a great job. I didn't see that part. All I saw was him, good job, man. And I'm like, really?
Yeah,
you
do that
in the courtroom?
I mean, but it's not like he did it and then turned to the crowd or whatever,
smiled or anything. He didn't acknowledge them at all. Face.
Yeah. He looked that man straight in the eye, you know, paused and smacked him on the butt, and it was cool.
Right.
The lawyer didn't flinch.
No,
nope. Not at all.
But
30 days, wow.
That's what 30 days get you.
That's what fame will get you,
man.
Tell me about it.
Oh, you think his career over now? I mean, I thought it was already over, but
yeah, he's done.
He's done.
It's no it's nothing he can really do at this point to come back because nobody's going to give him a chance.
And it's like all his setbacks have been in public eye. Yeah. Like last year with the NFL Hard Knocks series.
Right.
The dude cut him and told him why he cut him and everything.
Right.
And with this, with the Evelyn Lozada,
the whole reality thing. Show
stuff. Yeah. You know, it's just like, it's just too much, basically.
Yeah, I agree.
I agree. I wish somebody else would get it through their thick head that their career is done, too.
Who was that?
Terrell Owens.
Oh, he's done.
Yeah.
He'll be 40 this year, won't he?
See, he's close to it, if not.
Yeah, he'll be 40 this year. And I think now a lot of the stuff, a lot of teams probably would have gave him a second chance, but it just shows like how karma can swing back around to you.
Real quick.
From the past that you've done. You know?
And it's cool. And speaking of dumbass receivers.
Uh-oh.
Codeine.
Sipping on some scissor.
Codeine.
You talking about Josh?
Josh.
Now, you know what? All right. You know what? I'm going. First off, do you believe that it's codeine?
Yes.
Because some people out there saying they don't believe it's codeine.
And
because,
you know,
technically the rules in NFL, if you get what is the word I'm looking for? If you get suspended for the substance abuse,
right.
They don't have to disclose what it was officially.
Right.
And then he is the one that came out and said it was codeine.
Okay. And Nobody else came out and said it or confirmed it. That was codeine.
Okay, then.
I believe him.
Promethazine.
I think it was something more serious than that, he would have got the 4 games instead of just 2.
Because whatever he did plead his case and got that 2.
True.
Yeah. So I that's what I think. I kind of believe him that it was that. But then
that's just stupidity at that point.
Yeah, it really is.
Because it's like right now, if he got a strep throat or something, if he got strep throat, he can go ask the team doctors, what can he take to ensure that none of that codeine and stuff like that, anything illegal or banned,
they don't do that no more. They don't ask the team doctor.
Are you kidding?
They just go get it themselves or get it shipped through the mail and put their dog's name on it.
Well, that's why he got the 4-gamer then.
No, that's baseball. They do that. That's self-medicate and send it to your house.
But when you see stuff like that, you be like, damn, only in Cleveland. Oh, what are sports teams?
Yeah.
Man,
it's just crazy.
But in the NFL, man, it's an NFL franchise. He could have called somebody and said, "Hey, I'm sick."
Yeah.
Somebody.
And the thing is, he got to watch it now because the next violation,
it's a year.
He can get a year.
Yeah,
a year.
And you think Haslam and them gonna wait on him for a year?
No.
When he's not their guy, Lombardi already had his red flag on dude as it was.
Right.
So he really treading on thin ice right now.
Yeah. We'll see, man. We'll see.
It will be interesting.
It'll be real interesting.
Go Cleveland teams.
Yes. Man. I did see that there may be some more charges might be coming against Mr. Castro.
For real?
Yeah.
Yeah, man.
And he got like 300 in.
They went back into the
I'm house. Like, how many more charges can you put on the man? I mean, ain't 329 enough? I mean.
Wow.
I read that they
had got another warrant to go back into the house for some reason. I didn't know where it came up.
Supposedly, they found some more evidence that may have been more victims involved in that house. Yeah, that's what I read yesterday.
And they also said it was another person like 2 houses down.
Yeah, it was a rapist. Not a rapist. No, it was a sex offender. And the attorney general is actually putting more counts against Castro right now. That's the reason why the charges are up to 300 right now. I think there's like another 50 more coming to him.
Yeah.
So
hey, run it up on
him. Right.
That just shows, though, you never know what's going on in another person's house.
Yeah,
true.
That's true.
Because they say he's the type of guy to come out, have a beer with you.
Yes.
Never go in the house, though.
You feel me, bro?
You never go in the house. And the sick thing about it was that Gina DeJesus was like his daughter's best friend or something like that.
Yeah, that's just so crazy, man.
Sick.
That's just sick.
It really is sick. It really is.
That's all I can say. Sick.
Wow.
But on to lighter things.
Yes.
How about the draft is coming.
Oh,
please, let's talk about the finals.
No.
Does it look a lot like the Cavs, or is it just me?
It does.
Looked like the Cavs until Thursday night. It looked like the Cavs.
But that's one game.
Yeah,
like,
one game.
Like, if we go back in history, like, wasn't Mo Williams giving us games like that every once in a while?
He was giving it like that all the time during the playoffs.
Okay, I just wanted to throw that out there. That's all.
And Bosch was just...
Yeah, Bosch just had a special game, you know. That
he didn't decide to come to play till Thursday.
They needed all that to just stay
yes,
in.
Yes, they did.
Yeah, because if they didn't, it was over.
I knew they was in trouble when Wade did the old, you know, over the head.
Oh, you're talking about the
thing.
Euro step?
Yeah, it was. Like, I was like, oh.
He went back to Dwayne Wade 2006.
He must have got the good shots before.
Sure
the game.
Did. Yeah. Sure did.
And yeah, he showed out a little bit.
Yes, he did.
It's all right, though. It's all right.
But they look a lot like the old Cavs. I'm going to just throw it out there.
Everybody stand around and watch LeBron do everything.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Looks real familiar.
Sure does.
He went, you know, hey, come on back, buddy.
We'll see what happens in game five.
Yeah, I think the Spurs going to put it back together.
Think so?
Yes.
We'll see.
Because defensively, they got it. I mean, the thing that's a problem for the Heat is it looks like Dwayne Wade can't guard anybody. It's like whoever he has.
He can't guard Green.
Nope.
He can't guard, well, he wouldn't be guarding Leonard anyway.
Nope.
But he can't guard Neal.
He can't guard Neal. He can't slide over and guard Parker.
Nope.
Nope. See, that's what I mean. He's a defensive liability right now. And I think that's what Popovich is exploiting.
And, right. And that's crazy. You would have never would have thunk that.
Right.
You didn't think his decline would be so drastic.
That bad.
So,
right.
I mean, that's my problem. Is just he's like he's falling off, but he's like falling off quickly.
See, I'm not going to take him that far. I'm not going to. The dude's still a star in the league.
Oh,
he can still get it as he proved, but he's been banged up. He's not, he's not 21, so he's not healing as fast.
All them days is done.
Like, he can only put it together every couple of games. And
Right.
I don't know if he can hold up for two more years. So
I don't know.
LeBron, we got Kyrie.
Right. Well, we got a good show going for us.
No doubt.
The rest of the way, we're gonna go break in a few minutes. But I'm excited too. We have the producers from the movie Swing Low, Sweet Chariot in the building today.
No doubt.
You know, it's
delighted.
Very delighted. You know, if y'all haven't checked out the trailers, y'all really need to check it out, man. They're doing big things for the city of Cleveland with this movie here. And I'm really excited myself to, you know, to have these people on the show to talk about the movie. Right. You're in awe.
I'm in awe.
I like that. Yes. Yes.
It's so, like Ron say, we in a place with superstars here tonight.
So definitely, when we come back from break, we definitely going to have them on the set here. They're going to take over. You know, it's already an East Cleveland takeover here in the building right
Shaw
now. We're going to talk about that.
Shaw
High is in the building.
Hey, you know, Shaw and Glendo are both in D2 now.
I don't care what division. We in the building right now, brother.
You a hater.
Oh, my goodness. He does not want.
You a hater.
Why I got to be hating?
Because you are. That's
you
it.
You just did it.
Yes. Man. You know what? You get off to the side, man. Cut his mic off, man. Well, we're about to
I ain't got no comment right now.
That's the good hood point.
That's right.
On the MSC Radio Network.
Yes.
You're listening to Morning Show Central Radio Network. The following message is for those with a credit score of 800 and below. Who wouldn't want better credit? Did you ever wonder how different life would be from just having a higher credit score? Are you tired of being turned down for any kind of loan or only offered high interest rates because your credit score is holding you prisoner? Life doesn't have to be that way anymore with access to Turnscore. By increasing your credit score only 50 to 100 points, it can potentially save you tens of thousands of dollars in interest over just a 5 to 10 year period. It can be the difference difference in getting approved for a personal loan, business loan, high limits on credit cards, a brand new car lease, or even a home mortgage. We see so many ads from companies that give us our credit score. But once we get our credit score, what are they going to do to actually repair your credit? Unfortunately, nothing. Until now, Turnscore is the first automated credit repair platform that is simple, safe, and secure. You'll be empowered right from the comfort of your own computer so you can challenge and repair your credit report to ensure it's fair and accurate. Turnscore is specifically developed with you in mind. There's no more need for an attorney, credit repair companies, or credit counseling. More importantly, no more need for paying higher fees. Turnscore will help you get back on track and get the buying power you need. So whether you have bad credit, average credit, or even good credit, Turnscore is helping turn lives around one credit score at a time. Go to Turnscore.com and enter the promo code MSC20 and get $20 off your purchase. That's TurnScore.com. TurnScore.com. Turnscore.com.
Him and Hein. See the top, but don't cut trap. We let my middle get in you. It's hard to slow a real nigga down. He got my name for Stevie Stone. Two men.
Well, I'm back home in an extension. I straddle your opposition. They playing me, huh? They playing. Now I'll be ripping. Motherfucker want to cheer me, but I say it and feel the chairs in the hip because I'm loud and abrupt. When I speak, the ground shake and the stiffest strangers are Homa. I'm on it. Godzilla can hear me around the corner. I'm on it. I'm an animal, vicious, you know I wanna. I'm on it. Some fire, Tony, bad bitches sipping Corona. Unleash, elite, figure. Boy, in the middle of the 5-7 triple. I am that nigga. 30,000 more men. Worthy, make a nigga wanna serve me more. Hold him with venom. I'm out of wild. Inertia, nigga. No gravity around him. I'm pushing on him. The money count. The fire on the scene. Rain on water fountain. Step out. I pray. Momentum. I'm on it. If I see it, I want it. I go and get it. I'm on it. If you're looking for competition, come get it. I'm on it. Rolling stone. Keep rolling and rolling on. I'm on it. Momentum. I'm on it. Momentum. I'm on it. Momentum. I'm on it. Momentum.
Plus, with the option to add auto DJ and on-demand service.
services, you can be confident your station will be all it can be. Custom plans are also available at their website. Simply visit jwnmedia.com and click the Shoutcast hosting link to get started right now. Hey, local bands and unsigned artists. What if I told you there was a place in Cleveland where you can get your merch made and have it sold in one location? What if I said you could bring your CDs and tickets to upcoming shows to this location? And what if I said you could do live acoustic sets at this location? I bet you're thinking there's no such place in Cleveland. Guess what? You'd be wrong. Contact Rick Navario at Rock City Cleveland and tell him you need merch made and you want to sell it in his store. Now, how cool is that? You can tell your fans to come down and get your stuff, and I think he'd ship your products to your fans. And he's local. Contact Rick Navario at Rock City Cleveland today, 216-622-0377. That's 216-622-0377. If you have a product or service, let people know about it. Get your message out there and advertise on MSC Radio Network. It's easier than you think. And the whole planet is listening. Find out how you can advertise. Email Chris at morningshowcentral.com. Pete99 Technologies. Affordable and reliable web hosting done right. Jumping from one web host to another can be frustrating. Finding a good web host can be unnerving for even the most experienced of web designers. That's why Uncensored Net Noise has chosen Pete99 Technologies as its web hosting supplier. Established in 1999, Pete99 Technologies has evolved into a first-class web hosting provider. Its 99.9% uptime rivals many in the industry. That's why they offer their 30-day guarantee. No questions asked. For more information, go to P99.com. P99 Technologies will help you get started with your web presence. With honest and expert customer service. P99 Technologies. Affordable and reliable web hosting done right. If you're looking for the best in musical equipment, recording gear, sound reinforcement, and more, Guitar Center has you covered. Guitar Center, located at 26635 Brook Park Road in North Olmsted, has the tools of your trade. With the largest selection of music and sound gear in the area, they cater to your musical needs and have the knowledge to help you out. Guitar Center in North Olmsted. MorningShowCentral.com uses them. You should too. Need to know more? Go to GuitarCenter.com. User-friendly and ready to serve. MorningShowCentral.com. Having problems with your home computer or business PC? Looking to have some upgrade work completed on your computer? Have a special project in mind that may be too much for you to undertake alone? Time to call
Joe the Printer Guy!
Joe the Printer Guy offers a full-service hardware and software repair center at his facility to handle your PC, server, and networking needs. Let their professional service staff handle your computer needs. They offer expert service at an affordable price. Visit Joe the Printer Guy at 1403 Madison Avenue, Lakewood, Ohio. Online, JoeThePrinterGuy.com or give him a call at 216-651-3880. Joe the Printer Guy.
I know. Oh my God, I know what we're gonna do. Oh, it's so delicious, I can almost taste it.
If you're looking for the best sub shop in town, look no further. Hanini Subs, located at 7310 Lorraine Avenue, is the place for you. Stop in for a cold cut sub, cheeseburger and fries, wingdings and fries, and so much more.
I can almost taste it.
Hanini Subs at 7310 Lorraine Avenue is open 24 hours a day. Check them out on Facebook, facebook.com/burrito crazy. And if you mention MSC Radio Network, you'll get $1 off your meal. It's all good at Hanini Subs.
So damn good.
Oh, wow. Language.
Okay, he was PMSing.
You're listening to Morning Show Central Radio Network.
Conversation.
Yes, yes. And as you see, we have expanded. We have more bodies up here right now.
We got a full house.
Yes. And we would like to introduce to you all the production crew, the producers of the blockbuster movie here from Cleveland, yes. Ohio, Swing Low, Sweet Chariot.
Representing.
Yes.
No doubt.
You all want to introduce yourselves, and we go from there. We have... Miss Cherie Scott Worthy here, John Del Cerrone here in the middle, and Tina Hobbs over far to my far right over there. Welcome to the Hood Point, you all.
Yeah. Yes. Happy to be here.
Thank you. Yeah, happy to be here.
Yes, yes. So, let's see. Just tell us about, give us a little bit about the movie. For those that don't know about the movie that's coming out, the premiere is next week. Just give us a little brief about the movie and how did you all come up with the idea of this?
That's actually a good question, because actually I met the author of the book. This is an urban drama book written by Stella Hall, Cleveland's own Stella, and me and my cousin Dave, who's the director of the film, we're co-owners of HWIC Filmworks. We shot her play, The Bridge of No Return, last year. That was at Tri-C, the Metro campus.
Yes. Yeah.
So that's how we met her, like that way. So then when I went to meet her on at the library on 105 in Superior, we met down there, and she wanted to give me her she was paying me to do the play or whatever. So she gave me she's like, you want to, get a copy of the book, a couple of my other books, because we're looking to do something along these lines or whatever. So she gave us the book. I sent it out to Dave. He read it and was like, hey, this is, we can make a movie out of this for sure. You know what I mean? And it already has a built-in audience. It's all based in Cleveland. Everything about it, everything's Cleveland, basically, with the book and stuff. So,
wow.
Yeah.
That's good. That's good. So once you all got that together, how hard was it getting a cast together for the movie?
Well, that was her job right here. So let me tell you about that. That wasn't easy. Okay.
Yeah, my name is, we actually have a casting company. I'm a casting director.
Oh, okay.
So teamed up with John and Dave, and, they brought the book and was like, this is what we want to do. So in addition to casting, I also became a producer on the project, which was so much fun. But we held a casting call. We had actors come in from all over. They came in, they auditioned. We had quite a few casting calls. Some of the cast that we have, was just easy to find. We just, they came in, they did their thing. We were like, okay, that's, Graham. That's, the most difficult role that we had was with finding Chariot.
Gotcha.
But it was all worth it because Phalia Thomas, who plays Chariot, came through after, maybe our fourth call?
More than that.
Oh, wow. Is she local also?
And she is local. Yeah, she is local. And she did a phenomenal job at the audition and was well worth the wait. So, So, yeah, we had a call and it turned out great. The cast is awesome. When you see the movie, they are bringing it. So, good things.
That's good. Now, is the whole cast all from a...
They're all local? From Cleveland, Ohio. They're all local.
Except for Chuck D, who plays a DJ. He plays a DJ in the movie, right? Gotcha. And then a guy named Tony King, who played... Do you guys remember the original Sparkle?
Remember the original Sparkle.
He was in Bucktown.
He was
in The Godfather, The Toy. Yeah, wow. He's a friend of Chuck's, and that's how we hooked up with him.
Oh, okay.
So,
wow.
But they're the only two that weren't from Cleveland.
I got a question.
Ahead.
How did you hook up with Chuck D?
That was going to be my question we get all the time. Well, Dave... First off, we're both huge Public Enemy fans, you know what I'm saying? And Dave's a real big Public. He always was, you know what I'm saying? So he followed him somehow on, this is back in like the late 90s, like when the internet was just getting started stuff. He started like going onto the Public Enemy sites and stuff like that and emailing and stuff. So eventually he met him here at Cleveland State or something like that, and they ended up meeting up or whatever. Then he built a relationship up with him, and then eventually Dave gave him some of his videos and stuff, and Chuck saw the videos and loved it, and Chuck likes Dave and me doing his videos because he doesn't have to wait around, he doesn't like to sit and wait and stuff, but we're like guerrilla filmmaker. Like Dave goes in there, he just shoots it and boom, he just gets it done.
Shoots it, boom, puts it out right.
Chuck loves that, so that's how we linked up with him and stuff, so it's been a relationship, man. Public Enemy's been like family to us, and I know I'm cool with him, but Dave's really, he's like in their group, but he's produced a few songs for him. He produced How Low, the theme song, Dave produced it, and then
which is Chuck banging. Related.
It's banging, yeah, man. Right,
right. Yes, it
man.
Is.
Appreciate it.
Yes,
that.
It
cool.
is.
Yeah,
I like how you call him Chuck. Chuck feels like.
Yeah. And they will be at the premiere June 24th. They will be in Cleveland. The next day is the King of Mike tour, so they'll be at the they'll be doing the show. So,
right.
Yeah, yeah. So they will be there, the whole group.
Public Enemy in the house. Flavor Flav, right?
Man. Hey, guess who I'll be hanging with?
Yeah, right. Yes, exactly. Yeah, we
definitely. We want to.
Is he gonna bring his favorite for Flav Love girls back?
Let's see, here you go. Yeah, we definitely we definitely gonna be in the building for that, man. We definitely want to be there for that. No, got to check that out. You know, any way we can support, and you know, like we've talked, me, John, and myself talked, man. Any way we can help you all, and vice versa, help us with, you know, with our show and things like that, man. You know, let's make it happen, man.
I'm a pretty good actor. I just didn't get the call. I'm sorry.
You got to sign up for my website.
I'm signing up. No, I'm signing up.
So how long did it take to do the whole filming process for the movie?
We started September, I believe.
Actually, yeah, late August, early September.
Yeah, right. We started shooting. So it was sometime in September. That's all I really remember. But we ended early December. So we would shoot on the weekends because a lot of the actors, you know, obviously they have regular jobs and stuff. So we shoot from Friday through Sunday most of the time. And they would, and we just like get as much as we could in and then, you know, and then start, you know, come back the next weekend and, you know what I mean? You know, it was that was like, actually the lead girl, Chariot, Phalia Thomas, she would organize everybody on Wednesdays and they would get together when they would get the schedule for the weekend and she put everybody together and they would like block all their scenes, go in and do it, you know what I'm saying? And study everything. So that's how they did it. Yeah, that's how we did it.
That's dedication. That's
Sharice, why are you so bad? We at home, Sharice, come on now. Relax.
Those are questions that John can answer. I came in at the end of the project, truthfully. I hooked up with Tina because I had read the book. Okay. And I saw on Facebook that Tina was saying stuff about, you know, this movie, that they were making it into a movie. And also I had met Stella because I met her a couple of years ago when I bought the book from her.
Okay.
And so when I saw the two of them collaborate, I was like, I want to be in on this. So needless to say, I had a friend who had a friend that got in contact with Tina and said, this girl wants to be a part of this. She wants to get into this business. She wants to learn. And so Tina was nice enough and brought me in, and John was nice enough to put me in the movie and everything. So all it was right. Great.
And Sharice came in, guns blazing. She just fell right in. Yeah. We were like, oh, we needed her.
Yeah, where were you the whole time?
That's good. That is
That's
good.
That's real cool. That's real
yeah.
cool.
So
how's sales for the movie? I mean, for ticket wise, are they going pretty
good? Yeah, they're moving. They're definitely moving. You know what I mean? I think, it, you know, well, first off, it was kind of hard because everybody thinks movie, they think they got to show up that day and buy a ticket. So I think that confused a lot of people. You know what I mean? They realize they buy their ticket. You know, but they could go buy it. You know, and here's the thing, too. The after party is going to be a limited amount of people because we're having a release party right next door at the Macklin Center next to Solon Cinema.
Gotcha.
So, you know, you might be best going to get your ticket now at swinglowtickets.com. That's swinglow with an E. Tickets.com to get your tickets because you don't want to miss out on this. I mean, this is going to be probably one of the biggest red carpet events in Cleveland. I mean, this is it. I mean, you got the celebrities coming. You know, Tony King, he'll be there too with Public Enemy. So, I mean, you got a guy. Okay. He played in the NFL too. He was the first guy to play on a team with his brother, like the brothers on the same. They played for the Bills the same time Marty Schottenheimer played with the Bills.
Oh, really?
So he was in the NFL too. So.
Wow.
So it's going to be a star-studded event.
Yeah,
and Ray Jr. will be there. You know, rapper Ray Jr.
Yeah.
From EC.
From EC,
baby. Right. EC.
We're doing it all.
That's right. That's right. Yeah, definitely. We definitely going to check. We checking it out. I'm trying to be in the building to see this. You know, this is one that always, I love my town. I love Cleveland.
Right.
And,
right.
you know, even though I do make comments that I want to move, that's for health reasons, but but you know,
we don't get hit by tornadoes and stuff.
That's
man,
true.
I keep telling
that's
you, man.
Yeah, that's true. That's true. And you know, I love the change of seasons here. I love that. You know, that's the beautiful part.
Yeah.
So, but you know, anything that I can do, we can do to help promote Cleveland. I mean, it seems like we always get a bad rep on so many things, man. And
yeah, that was our goal too with the movie. You know, we wanted to bring everybody together because, you know, it's like being the story takes place in Cleveland, you know, the authors from Cleveland, the actors from Cleveland, the music's, you know what I mean? We really wanted to bring a lot of pride, and we're getting that with the trailer. People are saying, hey, there's a lot of pride, you know, and I knew you were saying that, you know, and that was a big thing. And I think we do get a bad rap here, you know what I mean? Because, you know, and everybody talks about how Cleveland's got all these haters and stuff, but, you know, people were supportive. I mean, this movie was, it was easy to get locations. And I mean, am I right, Tina? I mean,
yeah, we received a lot of love. Like, all the establishments that we were able to use, they were like, yeah, you know, anything to support Cleveland. We received a lot of love. Right. So big shout out to, we shot at Executive Lounge, Grown Ups Martini Bar, which is Tyson Mitchell, also from Shaw High.
Tyson.
The dog pound.
What's up, Tyson?
Right.
Man.
Hey, Tyson.
That's my boy.
The Dog Pound, which is Fred, which is also EC, Travis. Where else do we? Roots Barbershop, Wendell Lovelace.
Wendell Lovelace. Yes. Desdale Bartley. That's family right there.
I think big shout out to the old Big Q. Because we got a lot of it there.
Sing the hook, John.
So,
No.
Oh, she put you on the spot, John.
No, we're not going to do it now.
Right. Everybody will quit watching if I do that.
Right. Nesbitt Funeral Home. I'm missing some.
We shot we shot all over Cleveland. And really in the city of Cleveland a lot.
It was a lot of hood.
Yeah. And then we shot a little bit in Euclid and a little bit in University Heights, but most of it was shot in Cleveland, you know.
So, that's good, man. Yeah. That's good. You know. So, you know, I know this is the big thing now. Once this this train slows down a little bit, what you have on deck after that? Are you going to keep on
moving? Well, there's a rumor going around. I'm not going to, you know what I mean? I'm not going to condone anything, but there's a rumor going around.
Exclusive here.
This is exclusive on the hood point. There's a rumor going around that Swing Low 2 is in the works. You know what I'm saying? But I don't.
You know what? I saw a picture on y'all's site that had a picture of Taraji. Megan Good. And like, would she be in Swing Low 2? I'm like, whoa, really?
Right.
What?
Hey, what did they say? I ain't one to gossip, so you ain't heard it from me.
Check out, if y'all get Swing Low 2, I just want to be extra. You know.
Right. Yeah, we get that all the time. Man.
We need lots of extras.
Right. Well, the good thing about this, though, this way, like, because Swing Low is getting so big and so much press, people will know about, you know, a lot of stuff that's happening. If there's a second one, you know what I'm saying? They'll know where to go and what to do. So,
okay. Yeah.
If you need radio guys, radio scene, I mean, we got you.
Yeah.
All right. We're right here.
Right. Okay.
And it's authentic.
I think that's a hint.
Right.
Right. Everybody's throwing hints out today.
You see, I got you.
We got to use that EC connection.
Yeah, that's right.
Hold on. Don't jump on that EC connection, brother. You ain't part of that.
Yeah, that guy's trying to always hate on us.
Right.
And now he want to be down.
Yeah.
I started off playing baseball in EC.
That's not good enough. If you don't know nothing about Sioux Sub City, leaving school to go over to Sisters
Chicken
and Heroes. How many got sent to the office because they smelt like oil from Mr. Heroes?
That would be me. I went to Angela Mia's back when you could eat in.
You know, we have a lot of actors from EC in the movie too, right? How many are from Troy Harris?
Yeah.
Dia Brackens.
Yeah. Right. I just found out this morning. My brother-in-law told me that Troy was in the movie.
Troy doing his thing in the movie.
He's been real supportive too, man. Big shout out to Troy. Like, he's been really helping us out big time.
That's good, man.
And who else? Kadia Brackens. East Cleveland, a couple. It's like 4 or 5 actors from East Cleveland. Yeah.
Man, they just too short, man.
Part 2, we got you.
That's right.
If.
Right.
No.
It's the key word.
If. Right.
When.
Just bless me with a part of being an extra.
There he goes with that trying to jump.
I'll take your name down as extra and give it to Tina.
Oh, man. Yeah. What's some other things we get? How did you assemble the roster for the soundtrack?
That was a last minute sort of decision, you know, because with the music we didn't really talk about it much, and that was, you know, something that shouldn't have happened that way, but it did, you know. But I reached out to a good friend of mine, DJ Big Fats. Shout out to DJ Big Fats. He's from the Heights, you know what I mean. He gathered everybody, you know, and we got everybody together. He put a word out. Everybody, you know, sort of came together, like as far as pushing the word and sharing everything. And we got So we got a bunch of submissions. So we got the submissions. Me and Dave went through them, figured out what we're going to use and not use. Because one thing about a movie is, too, just because your song's good doesn't mean it's going to be in the movie. It's got to fit the mood. That's, you know, you got to put a hardcore, you know, hood song in a love, you know, in a sex scene. You know what I mean? There are, there's two sex scenes in the movie. You know what I mean? Because and people forget that. They think, well, just I got a good song, it's going to go in the movie. You know, and it didn't happen that way. You know what I mean? So everything fit the scenes. So we got, you know, we got people from all over Cleveland. You know, we got a... Ray Jr., he actually put a song in it. We got Skrillogy, A-Rod, if you know him, he's from East Cleveland, those guys. He's down with all those guys. Yes. And we got like a lot of people came through for us. And the good thing was we got R&B too. You know, so because it was like, okay, we're sitting there thinking, that was the one thing. Because at first we got all these, you know, straight gangster songs. And we're like, we need, you know, some kind of
music. That's Cleveland, man.
Right, exactly. Yeah, right. You know, and not that there's not a lot of gangster scenes in the movie, but we needed other, you know, there's love scenes and, you know. And so, we got a lot of different music and it worked out, man. That was probably one of the biggest surprises of the whole thing.
I was shocked when I downloaded the soundtrack. You know, I'm thinking, okay, maybe it's about 12, 14 songs. Still going, man. How many songs is on the soundtrack? Yeah. Goodness.
Now, how many submissions that y'all took for the soundtrack, and then y'all broke it down?
It was like Fats told me, because he actually weeded out some of the stuff first that he knew wouldn't work. But it was like over 100 songs or something. People really came out and supported. You know,
that's major love.
It's a big music city too. You know, everybody's doing it, so that helped us easily. You know. And we figured we could cross promote. You know, their songs in the movies is going national. You know what I mean? They see us, we see them. And so it worked out perfect, you know, because everybody's getting shine, you know, from Cleveland. And it was great because it's all Cleveland music. So once again, Cleveland actors, Cleveland movie, Cleveland, you know, the whole package together. So that's what's nice about a movie.
I love that.
You know, you can all collaborate, right? You can't do that on a song. You can only have one or two people, but in a movie, you could have music, actors, you know, everything. So it brings it all together. So,
gotcha. Yeah. Now, once you all have the premiere, what's next with the movie? You're gonna be anywhere else with, you know?
That's a good question. I'm working right now on a theatrical tour, so we're gonna go like Akron, obviously, because you know they're so close to us and you know and connected and stuff. But we're gonna go to possibly Detroit, Columbus, Pittsburgh. So I'm working on that now and that's another thing too. We're gonna be the first movie released on Chuck D. He has his own music label, Spit Digital. That he uses, so he's gonna have he wants to start his own movie label. So we're gonna be the first movie that's gonna go on VOD, like video on demand.
Yeah.
So we'll be on iTunes, Hulu, Roku, all those places.
Really?
Too, so.
This is history. We're
part of it. Right, and the hood point is part of it, baby.
No doubt. Wish I could have been in the movie though.
Like I said, I'll take the extra position for the next one.
Because it's gonna blow up.
Oh yeah, it's definitely.
I see it, man. That's a great project.
Yeah, everybody that I point to look at it, you know, they like, man, I gotta see that, man. Yeah. And, you know, people are like, they're gonna be on your show. Yeah, they're gonna be on the show, man.
Yeah. The hardest part was getting people to watch the trailer, but as soon as they watch it, they're hooked.
Oh, they're hooked.
Now one person they watch it, go, oh, I gotta see this.
Right.
When I seen it, like, I was like, hey.
Okay. Hey, did y'all like that song too? The I Rep Cleveland, was that perfect or what?
That's perfect.
Or what? You know what I mean?
Man.
I was pumped. Like I said, I was sad.
Yeah, I love it. I tell you, every so often, when I get on Facebook, let me watch the trailer one more time.
Right.
I like it. Feels good. You know, it's home, man. It's good to see good things coming out of hometown. I can't say that enough. I love to see Cleveland do good things, man.
Right. Well, you saw the reviewers were comparing it to Boys in the Hood, Men's Society. Yes. Did you see that? I mean, that's...
Yeah.
I mean, you can't, you know, you're not
gonna... How does that make you feel?
Well, that's... Right. When we saw that, it was, you know, that's validation. Yeah. That's validation, you know, for what we've been doing, right? I mean,
definitely.
You know, I mean, all the hard work. I mean, it was a lot... Movies are a lot of work, man. I mean, it's...
I can believe it.
I mean, big shout out to Tina here, because, I mean, she did a lot of the organizing. She put people together, got the locations. I mean, it was a lot... You know, that's a lot of work.
Thank you, Dan.
Yeah. You said we're allowed to cuss on here, so it's a lot of fucking work. You know what I mean?
I know, that's right.
Right.
Right. I didn't say that. You're stressing that enough.
Yeah, John's at home now.
Right. Kick my feet up.
There you go.
Right.
That's good. Now, how many, I saw something that you're going to have it in several movie theaters. I mean, at Solon. It's going to be in like a couple... Yeah. Not just going to be in one theater.
Correct. That's actually good. Nobody's even asked. That's a great question. Because it'll be playing at 5 theaters at the same time. We have the whole wing. The whole wing will be there. So it'll be simultaneously playing starting at 7 o'clock. It'll be playing in all 5 theaters at the same time. So,
Gotcha.
And that's on June 24th, right?
June 24th.
Let's get that out PM. There a couple of
right,
times.
Right.
Yes.
Monday, June 24th, Solon Theaters. 7 o'clock, and then, like I said, Public Enemy will be there because the show will be the next day with LL and the Kings of Mike tour and Ice Cube stuff. So Public Enemy will be there. Don't ask me what theater they're going to be in because everybody wants to sit in the theater with Public Enemy. We're keeping that. We don't know yet. Maybe we'll split them up. I don't know.
Right. Look for me. Right. Look for me. All right.
Definitely, yeah. I'm excited. Yeah, I don't understand. I'm really excited, man. You know,
there's a lot of landmarks, but you guys will see, man. There's a lot of places in the movie. You know, things. Like, you know.
Just in the trailer alone, right. like I said, I'm like we discussed before. I felt so much pride just seeing just stuff I know.
I've walked past. I've been
into these businesses. I've seen these places. It just made me feel good. Now to know that everybody involved with it was basically from here. I mean, I'm just.
Right. And that's been the feedback from most people. You know, just the pride, right? Like, you seem so sincere. That's what everybody else is. They just so sincere. Like, you know, it's like this really is, you know, it makes me feel proud to be from here. You know, that's the point. You know?
Right.
And
goosebumps.
Right. And it is a hood. I mean, it's a hood movie, and it's a hood story. I don't know if you want me to tell you the little synopsis.
Yeah, please.
So it's about a girl. She graduates from East Tech High School, top of her class.
East Tech.
East Tech.
We don't roof at the schools here.
My sister's from East Tech.
2 weeks before she graduates, her best friend dies. She's got two best friends. They call themselves the Three Musketeers. You know what I mean? And one of them dies, gets murdered, and that sort of starts to screw up her psyche a little bit, you know what I mean? And she starts getting a little messed up, gets in with the wrong crap. Well, really meets the wrong
guy.
Yeah, let's say that. You know what I mean?
Women, you know.
right, exactly. Yeah, the bad boy, you know. And she starts to find things within herself that she never knew were there. You know, she's got, you know, some deep-seated issues, I guess, you know. And she starts to find things about herself, doesn't realize that she's got some violence inside of her, you know what I mean? And it's kind of funny because it's one of those first like sort of hood movies that's focused around the female, you know, she's sort of she's the protagonist, if you will, you know what I mean? So she's, you know, the sort of, you know, the same way like Kane was in Men's Society or, you know, or Trey and Boys in the Hood or something, you know, it's focused on her. And you don't see that very often, those, in, you know.
You don't, you really don't.
Not in
you
know? Hood movies anyway.
Right, not in hood movies, right, especially.
I
so.
I can't think of any.
I know.
I can't either.
That's a first.
I guess maybe poetic justice in a way or something.
That's not real. I'm beyond it.
Right.
Yeah.
No. Oh, man.
I just got so much stuff going
through. Man,
Like, once you start getting all the reviews back and start reading all this positive feedback, and like you said, start getting all the feedback from just people in general. Like, did you just like start glowing inside? But
what was big was the last review we got because it was so positive. You read that, right?
I did.
It was very. I mean, it was awesome because it was. He said a quote. He said something there, and this was sort of our goal too. Is we understand the movie's got violence and sex, but you know what? Right. When you say you try to get a message across to kids, they're gonna listen to 2 Chainz or Megan Good or something before they're gonna listen to their teacher. You know what I'm saying? So we wanted to have something where kids can. There's a message in the movie. You know what I mean? But it's not like, you know, blatantly flowers and roses because kids aren't gonna, they're not gonna, you know, let's be honest, they're not gonna watch that. You know,
preachy stuff.
Preachy stuff, right, exactly. Right. So he put in this review, the guy said, this movie has a message. He goes, but also it's a movie that kids would actually watch. You know what I mean? Because kids aren't gonna watch, you know, some of the other, like the rosy stuff. You know, this is something, and I think that you hope that message gets across in the movie to the kids, you know what I mean? Because it's, you know, and it's not really meant for kids, but I mean more so the teenage, you know, group, you know, because they're gonna watch it. Even though the movie's not meant for them, they're most likely, you know, a lot of them
they'll
are gonna
see
watch
it eventually. Check they'll it out. See they'll eventually. See it before, you know, they'll see it before anybody else.
Right, probably. Yeah, you're probably. Right. So that was a huge, you know, in the review, that was big for us, you know. And by the way, every review says, and these are people from Cleveland, by the way, these are not Cleveland people. Right. They say, I feel like I'm in inner city Cleveland. Like when I watch the movie, I feel like I'm there. You know what I mean? And that's huge.
That is huge.
That you really, you know, captured that, you know, sort of, you know, environment. And that was big. You know,
that's
that was
good.
Huge.
That's good.
So, and we need that out there because it's like I talk to a lot of people from out of town and they just have a totally, like, just messed up view of Cleveland.
Yeah.
Just, and I never known why. It's like, you ever been to Cleveland? Oh, no, but I heard my cousin been there. And, you got to come here. It's a lot of real people. Exactly. It's a lot of down-to-earth people. Right. I think that's what scares people.
I get out of town a lot of times, too, and got friends all over. And, like, the one thing they say, like, yeah, I've been to Cleveland. Well, where in Cleveland? Where in Cleveland? You know, I was in
Akron or I was in Cleveland. That's not Cleveland, right. Okay?
That's true.
Yeah. Or the next question is, are you from Cleveland? You know Bone?
That was me. People asked me when I went down to South Carolina a few years back. I went down for Black Bike Week. Y'all know Bone?
Yeah.
Right.
Really? Really? That's the only thing you know about Cleveland? That's it? Right.
Yeah. And LeBron left.
Yeah, and LeBron left. Right. Yeah, right.
Y'all still mad? No.
No. No.
Check it out. I'm done with that. Cleveland dude anyway. True. So he's an Akron dude.
Right.
Yeah,
right.
It's good that you guys captured a Cleveland feeling. Yeah. Because, I mean, it's... Like, it's been captured in music a couple of times. True. I'm not going to say everything that comes out is, but to see it visually.
Right. And it takes place down the way, too. You know, so you're getting real down.
We teamed up with CMHA. They let us shoot.
Yep. Hey, my mother-in-law works for CMHA.
We did
shot,
right. We shout out to the CMHA. They were awesome.
Oh, okay.
I can't think of the department my mother-in-law works in, but she works for CMHA. Been working for them for 20 years.
Yeah.
Oh, that's what's up.
Yeah.
Oh, that's cool.
Yeah.
Shout out CMHA.
Right. Yeah, they were real supportive.
Another good friend used to be a landlord of mine, Goolsby. He's a... big guy with CMHA as well. So that's good.
They're real
man.
Helpful. Yeah,
that's good. Oh, that's cool. And we gotta get our tickets, man.
I'm
June 24th.
I'm on it.
We got 7:00 p.m.
I got tickets today.
It's like Sharice is slanging them out here.
We've been selling tickets outside the radio station.
Check out, just slid that in. Southern went quiet. She's like, I got tickets today. You
want to
go?
Right. Right. Yeah, we're definitely going. We'll be there. Yeah. Yes, the Hood Point will be in the building there.
Nice. Y'all need me to buy mine on air?
Right.
I'm going to be right next to Chuck. I'm telling y'all.
So any other things that you all are working on? I know we talked about, maybe collaborating on some other marketing things and things like that. You know, what are some of the other avenues you work on or deal with at this time?
As far as HWIC Filmworks, we do, corporate videos, music videos. So we do a little bit of all that stuff. But we really, our love is making movies, and you can't just go out there and say, hey, give me $1 million to make a movie. You know, and I get that. I'm not, that's why there is a Hangover 3, because it's like when the Hangover sells, they're going to milk that till it's done,
Right.
And we're just, guys from Cleveland. So we're trying to build our base here. And this is we're here to stay. I mean, we're going to keep making Cleveland like movies like this in Cleveland, urban dramas, and shout out to the authors out there. We want books that are Cleveland based and that we really want to turn them into scripts. That's the thing. That's what we're trying to do,
Okay.
But we do corporate videos. We do Route 21, the clothing store. We're doing their videos. Yeah. We do videos for Dots. We've worked music video-wise. We've worked with Dougie Fresh. We worked with DMC from Run DMC. We did a video with him and Chuck last summer. We worked with MC Light. Dave rode around with MC Light all day shooting a video. I wasn't there that day, but in New York. We've worked with all those. We got to meet a lot of the old school hip hop. We were in Dougie Fresh's townhome, hanging out with him in his studio, shooting a video and stuff. Wow. So we've been, Chuck's introduced us to a lot of people, man. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Cool.
Yeah.
Wow, that is. That's huge, Dad.
Yeah. And we're based out of Cleveland. People don't know that.
That's what's up. That's, cool. That's what's up.
People need to know that.
Definitely.
And if you ever think about doing a television show based on radio guys,
plug it.
Yeah, right. I'm trying to get us some
he
extra
is working
work,
over here, right?
Right.
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 I got to work with me. I'm trying to get
right.
This book. We got a real good story.
Right.
I'm just a nice guy, just willing to work hard.
And what about yourself, Tina? Anything you got down the pipeline coming out?
Yeah, I'm always working with, I do a lot with independent filmmakers. So always casting, check out my website, clevelandcasting.com, or send me an email, clevelandcasting@gmail.com. I'm currently executive producer of a television pilot with Skip Thomas Productions, Mike Berry. So, one of my goals, along with John and Sharice, is to build Cleveland as a film industry. And so, we're just requesting that if you're involved in the industry, you get involved. Just reach out and we can all help each other. We have a ton of resources, a ton of people, ton of talented people here. And we just want to kind of you know, get everybody together and build this as an industry.
All right, all
and
right.
People are believing you. She had an event called the Schmooze. What day was
the
it?
Schmooze.
The
Schmooze.
Yeah. When was that?
It was on May 11th.
May 11th. And mm-hmm. I mean, people came out and support. I mean, people are supporting this movement, like really big, man. It's really catching on. Because they're believing. Mm-hmm. I mean, because we're finishing movies, and we're making them, we're showing, you know what I mean, in television shows. I mean, people are believing in it, you know, and that's the most important thing.
It's official. When I looked at the trailer, if nobody told me that, you know, it was from Cleveland, and I would have been like, oh, this is live.
Right.
When does this come out for real? I mean,
You were supporting it just because of the hood movie, right? Like, this is good. I want to see this.
Exactly. The quality, the story, the everything.
Shout out
was
to
just
Dave.
Good.
Dave's cinematography is.
Yeah. Yeah.
On beat. Like, when you watch the movie, you are going to be just so in awe. Right. It's just he's the man.
Yeah, like, real talk, man. His cinematography, like, he's probably better than anybody in Hollywood. And he studied since we were kids. We've been making movies since I was 9, he was 12 years old. You know, like I said, we're cousins and stuff, so we've never stopped since. I mean, this guy used to edit on 2 VCRs, VHS style. I mean, the old VHS. Wow. He would literally pause and record. I mean, this guy's been doing it that long. He's that good. I mean, he's
I still do that.
And it's his passion.
He still does it.
Yeah.
Wow. Is that Dave?
Yeah. No,
that's
me.
No, that's Chris.
That was Chris. Yeah. I still do that. Oh,
well,
funny.
You know what? Real quick, though, the guys might like to come in and take a tour of the green screen next month.
Oh, yeah.
Well, here's
I've seen that. Yeah. We've seen that.
Well, just to let you know, if there's any artists out there or anybody that wants to come in and is doing filming or anything like that, next, actually, July 2nd, is an open house here at Creative House Studios too. You come in from 5 o'clock, actually it's 6 o'clock until 8 o'clock, and you'll be able to take a tour of the green room and everything else too.
Oh, awesome!
Awesome.
I'm gonna blog that to all my talent here in Cleveland.
Okay. Right. Awesome. And Sharice, you know how's the ride been for you so far?
You
ran out of bullets yet? They said you can't guns blazing. You run out of bullets.
No. It's been great. I've been sticking close to Tina. And so I am also working on the Skip Thomas productions of the
Third Floor West
TV pilot. So we are getting ready to, we shot one episode and we're getting ready to do the second episode next week.
Oh, congratulations on that.
We got to get y'all back for that when y'all ready to do that. Definitely.
And Sharice, you got to tell them about your personal goal as being a writer.
That's my
goal. Why you been so quiet?
I'm going to put her out there.
Thank you, Tina. No, that is my personal goal. My personal goal, truthfully, I write, and I want to write, and I want to write novels, and I want to write novels, turn them into movies, what he does, and or either into stage plays. That's what I've been really trying to do. So that's right now I'm in the middle of a book right now. So
okay.
That's good. You say you're in the middle?
I'm in the middle.
You can write a character.
right.
6'4", about 220. Radio guy.
That's good. My question is for any of you three want to answer. Now, y'all basically blazing a trail for future filmmakers, writers, producers. What advice would you give for somebody that's hungry and ready and want to get in the game but just don't know how to start?
You want to start? I always say just take the first step. Following someone who's doing it. I mean, John and I and Sharice, we're always looking for somebody who just want to come in and lend a hand just so that they can, you know, and that's a good way to get a feel of how this industry works. A lot of preparation, research. I mean, before, you know, 2 years ago, I had never done anything in film production. But, you know, just personal research, setting personal goals, making a timeline for yourself of where you should be and when you should be there, and trying to stay on track as much as possible. And you need help. Just, you know, reach out.
Yeah. I would say that this is a business. Remember that at the end of the day, it's the entertainment business. And even though we're independent, we're doing it locally, it's still a business. And that don't, you know, go to school on somebody that you want to be like. If you're an actor or whatever, go to school. Read the biographies of, you know, if you want to be, say, like Megan Good, right? Learn about her. Look what she's doing. See what she's, you know, just learn as much as you can about where you're trying to be at or where you're trying to go, you know, and understand that it's not going to happen overnight. Even with Swing Low, I mean, you know, we're not sitting here saying, oh yeah, we're multimillionaires now, we made this movie, you know, and it's very, it could very well get big and blow up, you know what I mean? It probably will to some degree, but just remember, don't have false expectations, because I think everybody wants to, you know, right. I want to grow up and be an actor, but well, it's, you know, there's a lot, you got a long way to go,
right? Right.
You know what I mean?
And that's right. It's not going to happen overnight.
Overnight, right. You know, I work close with the, you know, some with the girl played Cherry. Sometimes I'm like, you know, I try to explain to her, like, you're going to be a star because of this movie, but you got, you know, it's not like the end all. You know what I mean? You got a long way to go. Trust me, you know. So I tell everybody that. Just know it's a business and learn and study as much as you can. Like she said, research, study. Ask me, well, I want to be a movie producer, you know, blah, blah, blah. It's like, well, it's not what you think. And there's another thing, too. It's not all fun, you know? There's a lot of shit that's not fun to do.
I've been to the pizza store trying to get out.
Right, exactly.
All nights, yeah.
We don't have million-dollar budgets. You know, we're doing this stuff on shoestring budgets, you know what I mean? And that's, you know, this isn't like, we don't have huge investors behind us, you know what I mean? And so, and we probably will eventually one day, you know what I mean? But right now, we're doing what we can do. So just know it's not all glory, and, you know, there's a lot that goes into it. So
that's what I would tell. Off to a good start.
Very right, there you go. Start. Exactly. Very I appreciate start. That, man. Appreciate it. Well,
Chris is giving us to wrap it up.
You know? Yeah, that was.
But if you're hungry, be sure to check out Hanini Subs located at 7310 Lorraine Avenue for the best subs in town. And while you're in there, tell them the MSC Radio Network sent you and get $1 off on your meal.
Yes.
Go check them out.
Go check them out.
And everything.
Tomorrow at 9 a.m., if you're at Hanini Subs, you can pick up a raffle ticket to win a $100 gas card courtesy of Since 1974 Radio.
Okay, that's what's good.
You said 9 a.m.
So I can make, let me see. I can
Are we disqualified?
9 a.m. till 2 p.m., and then he'll come back here on the show Sunday and announce the winner. For Father's Day.
Hey, am I eligible for that, Chris?
Crew members are not eligible.
Damn.
I knew he was going to say that.
Anyway, be sure tomorrow to tune in on Father's Day. Shout out to all the fathers tomorrow.
Yes. And shout out to the mothers that are fathers as well.
And the mothers that played both roles.
Yes.
Be sure to tune in tomorrow to the Since 1974 radio show coming on at 3 p.m. with Ty Howes and Micah. On the Morning Show Central Radio Network.
Right. To our guests today. Tina, John, Sharice, we thank you all for coming out.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Much success.
Y'all got to come back again now.
No doubt.
Don't get too big.
Y'all got to come back if y'all get like the Emmy Award and stuff like that.
Yeah, you got to come here first if that happens.
Y'all can bring the Emmy and just put it right there on the desk right there.
Will do.
But thank you for coming,
thank
guys.
Thank y'all for
really
coming.
Really appreciate it. And I'm really appreciate
I'm so
you.
Proud.
appreciate that.
Yes. And, let's get out of here for Chris. Nerf.
Right.
Cut
you know,
here.
So he start putting the lights
out. Lights start popping off and everything. I'm your man, E. Rumble. Sean C. Keith Allen. It's the Hood Point. We'll talk to y'all soon.
MSC Radio Network.
MSC Radio Network.
And we out.
Peace.